Hey, man, it's time to hit the books. Time for Networking 101. Man, you could not pick up a networking magazine out there today that doesn't have virtualization seem like wrote on every single page. Man, that is the buzzword of buzzword bingo, isn't it? You know what? Virtualization is really probably one of our older technologies. It's older than switching. I mean, virtualization was invented back in the 50s by IBM as a way of time-sharing CPUs. See, what they figured out over there is that a CPU typically is not going to be running at its peak efficiency until you start loading that thing down. So to only put one application on it, really, you waste a lot of energy or a lot of power and all that stuff. So IBM came up with this method for sharing this stuff out. And then it actually got ported over to the networking side before anything else, right? Anybody remember AppleTalk zones? You used to zone your network up in AppleTalk so you could actually cut down on all the broadcast traffic. Those became VLANs. We used VLANs for years and still use them, right? So we can cut up our broadcast domains. We can split our networks up. And it's like having two networks in the same switch is what it really amounts to, or even more. Now, what we've realized as we're starting to get these higher-end servers and our licensing agreements are getting a lot more strict is that it makes a lot of sense to take a server that maybe only be using 8% of its CPU load and start adding more applications on top of that server, more operating systems. So now, instead of buying a server every time I add a new app, I'm actually just virtualizing all this stuff, right? You know that. So what does virtualization really mean? In a nutshell, what you're looking at is that on any piece of hardware, networking, servers, whatever, you have the hardware that actually runs the device. On top of that, you have the software that tells the hardware how to work, right? Virtualization is a little middle layer that sits right in the middle of all that stuff, and it says, hey, I'm going to separate you guys out here, and it's going to control the communication so that if anything happens, like if I have this operating system over here crash, it's not going to affect this one because my virtualization layer, that middle layer, is handling all that communication, that inter-process communication, and making sure everything works. Now, once that starts happening, then we can start to do some pretty darn cool things. Like we can take a virtualized machine and pull it from this server and move it all the way over to another server that may be clear across the state and give us some pretty amazing redundancy when it comes to it. Pretty darn cool stuff. Virtualization is going to be around for a long, long time, and it's definitely really cool to kind of understand it. But the thing to remember is no matter what it's virtualized, hardware, software, what everybody's saying, anytime you hear the word virtualization, always think of middle layer. That is the stuff I'm abstracting my hardware. It's telling my hardware, don't look at what I'm doing up here. The middleware handles everything. That's what virtualization is.